Just how much more content could you create if you could take your typed video or podcast script and have it spoken by a sophisticated computer program, a computer program that could mimic your voice so closely that listeners would have difficulty determining if that was really you speaking? That is the magic of Descript and its special feature called Overdub. There's a lot of cool things going on around here in the studio. I am trying to shoot more content, and as such, I'm now using a Canon M50 like everybody else. That's actually one of the reasons, you know, if everybody's doing it one way, that's probably a good reason. In any event, while I'm able to get the clean output out of the camera, I'm actually using it as my webcam. For whatever reason, I've been unable to turn off the eye focus. For this video, I'm going to go around looking like Deadshot. I apologize for that. I wanted to do this video now, today, because, you know, I've talked about Descript before, and other people have talked about Descript before, and they go, it's a game changer. It ain't a game changer. It's a whole new game. They didn't take this game and change it over to here. They just took that game and threw it away and came up with something totally different. I'm going to be doing a series on Descript because they have added so many new features. When you decide that you're going to do an overdub voice, so you pay for your subscription, you download your software, and you say, okay, I'm going to do the overdub voice. You're going to go into overdub, and it's going to ask you normally to create a voice. When you do, it's going to ask you to name your voice. I've called mine Orman Descript Pro. 18 different voice styles. We'll talk about those. Those are to help get different inflections. And then I can open training. Now, when I open training, normally it's blank. What I'm supposed to do is just talk for 30 minutes. You are required by Descript to do this first part, which basically says, I, the owner of this voice that you're listening to right now, give consent for Descript to create an overdub voice based upon this, blah, blah, blah. That's to cover them because we've talked about this before. It is very conceivable, especially now because the quality's really gone up, that somebody can take this, type you, having you said, yes, I robbed the bank and stole $82 million. And it would be a little tough for people to figure out, did you really say that or didn't? So you have to go through this legalese here. And then I went on and talked for 30 minutes. I'm not even going to bother showing you all this because it was just utter nonsense. I just said whatever came to my head. I talked about my shoes. I talked about the wall. The purpose of it was to get an accurate sound of my voice with whatever different inflections I might do. As I said, I babbled about this. I babbled about that. I talked about this thing, that thing. And I talked just as I'm talking to you guys right now. I talked like that for 30 minutes. I then clicked submit. You wait about 12 hours and then you will get an email saying your voice has been created and everything's fine and dandy and everything is good to go. At that point, I have a couple of different choices. I can pick a voice. Obviously, I'm going to pick my own voice right now. However, there are custom voices that you can get to do your own thing. And we've talked about that before. I've showed you examples of that before, and I'll share another example in this one here. I go in and now I just start typing. This is Orman Beckles. I am happy to be here today to talk about the new things going on in the studio. Now, what it's going to do after I stop typing is it's going to realize that this is an overdub because I've made it as such. You'll see at the screen there, it's going to say generating overdub. So it's looking at what I said, searching its massive database, trying to figure out exactly what to do. And then it will come back, as you can see on the bottom of the screen, and it actually puts the words and it's in purple because I'm in purple. This is purple. That's purple. And that's it. That's how long it takes. And now let's go ahead and hit play. This is Orman Beckles. I am happy to be here today to take about the new things going on in the studio. To take, he says. So I can fix that. This is one of those things I can say. No, you moron, to talk. It realizes I've made a change. It's going to go off. It's going to generate it. Sometimes it'll generate just that word. Many times it will generate the whole thing so that the cadence sounds good. We'll come back over here. This is Orman Beckles. I am happy to be here today to talk about the new things going on in the studio. This is Orman Beckles. That simple. This is Orman Beckles. I'm going to talk about the new, let's just say, the new studio. So get rid of that. Get rid of that. Comma. We have a lot of new things going on. And again, as I'm typing, it's figuring out I've made a change. It's making a change to the Descript. What I am super, super impressed with is their ability to, that they've changed, they pared this down. Before, I had to read for like 4 hours, 5 hours. Anyway, I had to read The Wizard of Oz, which if you've never read the book, it's nothing like the movie. There's tree trunks and there's all kinds of weird stuff. And the other thing was, it still had a little every time I talked. It was usable. And I'm sure if you've been following this channel, you've heard it a couple of times and said, yeah, that sounds a little off. I am so super happy with the quality of the voice now. This is Orman Beckles. I am happy to be here today to talk about the studio. We have a lot of new things going on. Okay. And the reason I said it's a whole new game is because there are other AI tools that I can use with this. For example, I have a membership to something called Copysmith.ai. They've changed their name like 7 different times. I'm not going to worry about it right now. All right. And it will create content based upon what I ask of it. It will go out and create original content. It takes paragraphs and things and pulls them together. They're completely checked. So I'm not plagiarizing. It's not copying whole paragraphs, but it's copying the nuance. And the, so I can come in and I can say, okay, I want to create a blog intro. It says, okay, it's going to be an intro. And it says, okay, let's see, let me go back over here. Let's come back over here. Okay. So we'll say handles. I'm supposed to create this other part that goes along with them. That's fine. So I'm going to come over here and I'm going to do a blog intro and it says, what do you want to do? And I'm going to say, I'm going to do blog intro. Now it says what language it's going to be, English. And I have a choice. I have neutral, friendly, funny, adventurous. I'm going to go with adventurous. And I'm going to say, candles through history. Oh, no, I don't care. I'm going to go ahead and hit generate. And it's going to use its AI to create some paragraphs here. So we have incense has been used for incense candles. I mean, oh, I like that. Oldest form of light. Let's see. Candles have been used for centuries. And I can even say, yes, I like this one. Keep going. And it will keep regenerating and keep changing. I'm going to take that. Now, remember now, this is totally new. This is not anything that has been written before. I could come back in here 10 minutes later and have something totally different. Now I can go in, I can make some changes to this. I can save this. Let's see. We lost our camera feed there. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and let's see which end did you know? Candles. Okay, I'll take this one. So I'm going to click on that. It's now on my clipboard. I'm going to come back over to Descript. I'm going to paste it, and it's going to realize that that's new text, and it's going off, and it's now making taking that paragraph and doing it in my voice. How insane is that? So for those of you who need to do podcasts, you literally could just take a topic about your podcast, feed it into this thing, get the output, take this output, throw it in Descript. It does it in your voice. Take that and throw it on your podcast. You are going to see an explosion of podcasts. I'm saying podcast, but obviously I could also use this as narration for a YouTube video. So if I decided I'm going to do a YouTube video on candles, and I'm not really sure what to say, I could go ahead and do this. Now, this should be fine now. And let's see, I'm Orman Beckles. I'm happy to talk to you today about, let's click in here, candles. I'm happy to talk to you today about candles. I'm going to let it change that just to match that. And again, it should take just a few seconds. And again, I'm doing this for you in real time so that you can see. I also know that there's a gajillion people hitting the Descript server. This just came out this afternoon and everybody is using it. All right, let's see what we got. So I'm going to come up here and click, and Bob's your uncle. Did you know that the use of candles predates the discovery of what was that? Come up here. Here we go. This is Orman Beckles. I am happy to be here today to talk about candles. Did you know that the use of candles predates the discovery of electricity? Before electricity was discovered, candles were used mainly for light. They were made from tallow or beeswax. Candles were also used to heat rooms before the invention of the electric light bulb. If you are interested in learning more about candles, then this blog is for you. See. Okay. Not perfect. The voice itself is perfect. You may feel that this guy may have bumped his head a couple of times because the cadence doesn't sound quite right. And this is where those styles come in. So I emphasized certain words, didn't emphasize certain words. And when I recorded myself saying, today we did such and such, and this is absolutely fantastic. And I can take that cadence and save that as a style, and then I can apply that style to an overdub. And I really wanted to focus on the overdub, but I'll give you one. I normally use Emily. Emily's very nice. And we'll click on Emily, and we'll click done. And now, of course, we have to say, this is Emily. Because I don't want her to say, this is Orman. And I'll say, this is Emily. And then I'll click and I'll switch to Emily, and I'll switch to Emily formal again. That comes with a couple of different cadences as well. And again, and you can see just how quick this is. I can change things, move things around. Now, Descript, I will be doing more videos on Descript because Descript is a full video editor. I'm just talking about one. This is one little thing inside of this program, and everything it does really, really well. One of the other things it does is it has a sound filter. If you're somebody that takes your audio and has to run it through Adobe Audition to remove sounds, and you're not as good at that as you would like to be, that's all built into this now. It has a little thing. You click on Sound Studio. You can tell it how much to apply it to. There's a gajillion things that we can do with this. So I think this is just about ready. I think the very first sentence is not done. And you can see it's got sort of this dotted line underneath. That's an indicator to me that it has not done it. What I usually do is make some minor change. And that minor change, as you can see, I added a period at the end. And what that did was trigger the engine to say, oh, I guess I got to take a look at this line again. And let's go ahead and hear what we have.
This is Emily. I am happy to be here today to talk about candles. Did you know that the use of candles predates the discovery of electricity? Before electricity was discovered, candles were used mainly for light. They were made from tallow or beeswax. Candles were also used to heat rooms before the invention of the electric light bulb. If you are interested in learning more about candles, then this blog is for you.
Okay. She sounds better. And again, in other videos I've showed you, we can actually go back and forth.
This is Emily. I am happy to be here today to talk about candles.
That sounds very interesting. Please tell me about candles.
Did you know that the use of candles predates the discovery of electricity? This is Emily. I am happy to be here today to talk.
This is why I wanted to share it with you. This is not a super, super long video, but I wanted you to see what the new version of the voice sounds like. This is just 1/1000th of what the Descript program is all about. If you enjoyed this video, if you got a lot of good ideas from this, please hit the like button. If you want to find out more about Descript, I have a link down below. You can try out Overdub, I think, for 7 days. And be sure to hit the subscribe button because I'm going to be doing a whole bunch on Descript. We also have some YubiKey videos coming up. There's a brand new YubiKey that has a biosensor right in it. So it not only can tell my touch, but it knows that it's my touch. So we've got a lot of stuff going on. If you really want to help out the channel, you can become a member. Members get access to all sorts of special content, and they get access to videos days before we release them to the general public. And then we also have some special videos in there that we just don't release to anybody else except for the members. Until the next time, this is Orman Beckles, aka The High Tech Nomad, signing out. I'd like to say a big thank you to all of the supporters who have become members. You ensure that this channel continues to exist, and I am profoundly grateful for all of your support. If you become a member, you'll get instant access to extra video content, as well as bonus links, access to live streams, and more. Becoming a member per month costs about the same as a large cup of coffee, so why not check it out?